Okay, so this is the upgrado caster, and having done a lot of research last night, what I learned is that it's going to be virtually impossible to get a bridge to fit this guitar, and it's quite common to find that with cheap Chinese strat copies. They come with their own special size gauge things, and the string spacing on this guitar was, on this bridge, was 10 millimeters on this little unit here, and I wanted to replace it because I want a decent sized block, so I got the Wilkinson thing, but this is based on 10.5 millimeters. So what I've done is I've drilled out the existing holes and filled them. You can see there with little dowels and plenty of glue, and I'm leaving those to set, give them a good overnight set, so I'm not going to do anything more with that today. Then what I will do is I'm going to put in the neck like this, and I'm going to put in the bridge, and I'm going to line up the bridge and mark the holes. Actually, what I'll do is I'll just for tidiness, I'll lacquer those so you can't see them, but then I'll line up some dummy strings on there and line them up on the bridge so we can get the positioning of the bridge exactly right. The forward and back isn't a problem, it's already established, but what we just want to get is the side to side, just to make sure it's exactly right. Now once I've done that, I can then drill out some fresh smaller holes and then place the bridge in, and we'll go from there. And it's as you can see, there's quite a considerable difference between the Wilkinson replacement bridge, which is a nice steel block, and the soft, small, light alloy thing. So I did that off camera because it's a bit of a, I don't know what the word is, not risky, but I had to really concentrate hard on getting those holes drilled right, because I had to drill them by hand, as the pillar drill, is you can't get a guitar body under there. So as it turns out, it's good, it's well done, and successfully drilled, so I'll be on to move on to the next stage. I also need tonight to order the pickups for this baby and anything else that I think should go on here, maybe even some strap locks, a couple of little bits like that. So for now I'm going to put all the bridge components back into the bag, and it's just, you know, it was a decision. Do I either keep looking for a kind of mysterious mythological replacement bridge that's done in 10 millimeter gaps, which is highly unlikely, or do I revert back to the existing bridge, which seems pointless having gone to the trouble of, well, it seems silly when we're upgrading everything else. So this is one way of doing it. Just drill it out, replace these things, and they're nicely flush with the surface so that the new tremolo will sit nice and smooth on there. And I'll, as I say, I'll also black these out so that they're flush with the... not flush is the word. The word I'm looking for is so that they're visually... in keeping, they're hidden anyway, so it's not an issue. Okay, so that's my phone probably interfering. So that's the work on the upgrade strat today. I don't think there's any more I can or want to do. The only thing that is remaining in the meantime is to kind of replace out all the components. And once I've had a good tidy up in here, I might actually set about doing that. But that's a nice, fun little task. Should be fairly easy. So that's first kind of major step towards the new bridge. I'll put all the other old stuff out of the way. So I'll leave that for now, come back to it maybe later on when we're doing the wiring. Okay. Now, I've brought this outside because I was in danger of finishing this guitar, well, not finishing it, but moving too quickly without documenting it. So since the last clip, what I've done is I've drilled and filled the old slots and they've new put dowel material in there, and then I've covered that over with some black lacquer. So now what I have is the new bridge positioned where I marked it up and lined it up with the neck and made sure the strings were all happy. And also I've got a fifth spring here which I might as well put in while I'm at it. So I'm just really, I was just about to put the neck on back, the neck back on, might as well, because we're at that sort of stage. So I thought, oh, I better get the video camera out. This isn't so good, this goes around the corner. So I'm just going to wear, I think we'll do without that fifth one. So slightly off centre. We don't need it anyway. So we've got four springs in the back there. We've got the tremolo. Tremolo working. The only problem with this is because of the quality thick looking thing here. It doesn't have, because it's much fatter, it doesn't have as much room as the other one had. So you can't do a kind of dive bomb on this. You end up stopping somewhere there. But actually, this is, I think this is really sort of Hank Marvin territory, if anything. A little bit back and forth. I'll try and set it for a bit of backwards and a bit of forwards, but you're not going to be dive bombing with this thing. So next in line, we have the neck. Of course, after this, the next major thing is the tricks, which arrived today. Soldering and stuff out here. We'll put the neck on out here. Oh, Thomas is bringing a cup of tea. Should I answer that girl on the thing? Thank you. Thomas? Or were you going to answer her? No? Was she talking to me or talking to you? Was she? She's a friend of yours, right? Possibly two of them aren't. I'm just going to double check these, make sure we're not mixing up. That's helpful. Just dropped it. Stay there. Are these substantially different? They look the same from here. They just feel slightly different the way they're sitting. I'm just going to do that thing where get the neck into the pocket and just hold it in place and put the first one in and tack in this corner first. And I'm brilliantly prepared. I didn't put the thing into the power drill, put it in the other one, which leaves me fumbling around. It's quite a heavy chunky neck, so it's quite hard to hold in position the way I want it. Okay. And what I really want is these things to go in smoothly, like they've been in before. And if there's any sort of obstruction or anything doesn't seem right, then stop. I've got crap in my hand right now. Oh. They're quite a lot in before I tighten it all up. What I want to do is just flip it over and check it for positioning. So I'm just looking for obvious gaps where anything might not be sitting correctly. think it's very important that this goes in properly at this point. I've got the torque set to 4, which will click when it gets to it. And then what I'll do is I'll do a bit by hand to add that last bit of tightening to it. It's quite exciting because we're now at the it's coming together stage. I'll do it this way, the conventional way of doing things up. Okay, there we have the neck reattached, our fabulously re-profiled neck, our tremolo. It's got a little bit of a crunch, I don't know what that's. It's crunching paint that's under there. Just be it's touching on slightly wet paint or wet lacquer. Once we get it going quite a bit, sounds pretty good. Okay, I need to go and answer a couple of emails which are probably making all kinds of noise on this video now. So there we have it, neck back on, tuners on, re-radius neck, new frets, leveled, ready to go. A couple of bits of marker pen need cleaning off them, judging by what I can see here. Two little bits. New bridge, bigger steel block, much better for sustain. And I think I'm just looking at this whether the springs actually are clear. Yeah, the springs are clear of the wood, so it's all working as it should. Yeah, good. Back in a minute. Right, so I don't know how well sound worked on this, but next stages for this thing is take the existing wiring, which is these three ceramic pickups plus the standard pots that came with this thing, and the job is to rewire the wiring and change out the pickups for these Tonerider single coils, which by all accounts sound fantastic. So basically it's a complete strip out from this. The only thing we'll keep is the knobs and the that's it, the knobs. The rest will change, and the reason I had to use this particular pickguard is because it's custom or bespoke to this guitar, so it's not a standard Stratocaster size or shape, which means kind of obliged to use it. This is, you can see someone's taken a knife to this previously, it slots underneath. So basically, we're going to take all of this off, put it off to one side, and rebuild it using those components, and then reconnect everything, and we'll be sort of heading our way towards getting this thing ready to play. And obviously, it'll need a good clean up. The nut will need setting. It also needs the sharp edges taken down here. But hopefully, when we've got all that done, we're going to get down to a much nicer to play guitar. The slightly wider spread of strings, the string spacing here will be about just about 3 millimeters more than on the previous setup. There we are. It's looking nice so far. Right, so I'll stop for now and just begin the process of taking the stuff off. I can do this pretty much here because we're just going to put this in a container. Right. So there's a complete setup. But what bothers me about this one is there's some loose copper wire sticking out. No idea why. So I'm sure it's not supposed to be. There you go, the old Chinese stuff. In the meantime, we got the plastic off. And give that a bit of a clean up. There we go. Non-standard, but it will do. In fact, it's the only thing that will do for this particular one, so no choices. And I'm going to stop and save this till later on, under laboratory conditions. Oh yeah, let's get that under there. Why won't it go under? Do as you're told. That's what bothers me. Interesting. Okay, I'm probably going to have to take the neck off again when it comes time to do this, to fit this, but there we have it. And it will sit something like this. It'll just about fit with our Tonerider. Okay, we'll cut there and we'll come back to this a bit later on. Hang this back up safely. Damn, I couldn't resist it. It's getting late. What time is it? 10:15. But I just couldn't resist getting the stuff out and doing one or two bits to the Maurice Maddison, as it's now known. So the first thing I've done is installed the switch and laid out all the parts so we know what's what, and got everything ready to go now. I've just tried installing this and haven't managed to do it. Come along. This pickguard doesn't quite, well, it's a non-standard one, so it's I expect somewhere along the line some difficulties, but that's because I always expect difficulties. Okie dokie, oh, the buggy thing. Right, so we've got various bits and pieces, and we have a volume pot, which is going to be the one up there, which is the alpha pot, A. So you just stick them in place for now. So we've got one washery thing. That's a shame. Let's borrow another one from somewhere. Okay, so alpha pot in the first part of it. This is quite a long shaft thing, but it's okay. Hopefully that will fit. We've got some what's this stuff? Insulation sticking through. Oh, it's come off. Right. That doesn't actually fit, so let's find one that does. May well also not fit. No. Okay. Don't have any spare ones here. Let's take that one out and use it around the front. Right. So we've got these pots. We'll put the pots in place and then we'll just follow the wiring diagram and install the pickups. The only tiny thing about any comment at all about these is that this one here, although it is the bridge pickup, it's supposed to have a blue lead according to this, but it doesn't. But that's not a big deal. There we are. And then we've got two tone pots, linear Bs. And we'll have them pointing away from each other. Sorry, towards each other. So we'll wire them up as shown there. This is a strat feels remarkably easy after some of the more complicated twin pickup, twin humbucker things. They're not that much more complicated, but they can feel like it when you're a relative newcomer. You've got the other linear B to go there. Lovely, lovely. Again, a bit of shielding coming through there. So I've got high hopes for this little electronics kit, because I just rewired my Strat JV Squire, Japanese Squire, with some, damn, with a new wiring kit, and it sounds brilliant. It's just brought it back to life. It's incredible. Now I've just realised that I have to cannibalise these springs and screws here, so that's okay. I'm glad I kept them all together. Just looking at the pickup covers, they're very white. We've got a cream tremolo arm, we've got a cream tip, we've got a white pickguard, and we've got white covers. And I just wonder if I've got anything that's a bit less white. It'll work, but actually, I'm not really sure I do. What's this? These are a bit less white, but they're probably less white because they're dirty more than anything. Actually, they're not bad. I quite like the look of those. I'm just putting them there for a minute while I just take out these things. Yeah. Feeling of, there's something nice about pickups when they are slightly different colour than the pickguard, and it's totally superficial and cosmetic, but I don't know. So these are the old ones from Mark's Strat, and I suspect they'll go in a bin. I honestly won't have use for them, and I certainly won't have use for them considering that one of them has got some stray wire sticking out somewhere. There you go. Broken wire. So I don't even quite know how that's supposed to work if it's got broken wire. So while I'm at it, let me just take out the have a look at these covers and see if there are actually any good. That's not the right part of the blade to use, Samuel. Okay. I think these are just yellowed through age. I don't know what they're off. Where are they off? Let's just have a quick look what it looks like in terms of... First of all, do they fit? Yes, they fit. They are a bit darker. I quite like that. If they do the same thing... No. These are... What are these? They're staggered pickups. They're tall. And I can't remember what they are. Hellfire. Okay, well, they're the wrong shape, ultimately. So I'm going to have to stick with these. It's not like the end of the world, is it? So... what am I doing? So, I have me pick up, go through, and cover, go through. That's not going to work like that, is it, Sam? Plonker. Be very, very careful handling these things because they are. Those tiny little fine wires. Right, but we need the springs on between pickup and pickguard. Yeah, not good. So we're going in with the bridge first. It's gone. Have you gone in? No. That has gone in. I think I'll just get me a drill bit. I'll do this. It's waxed wires. Really nice quality. There's not a lot of room to play with under here, so around the bridge pickup anyway. It's got to be quite straight and to the point. Okay, so that's good. It's in position. Then we go for middle, just double check it again, make absolutely sure it's got the M prefix suffix thingy. Anyway, I'm jealous now. I want a set of these for mine. I'm not sure I can. You can't really see because I'm doing this right-handed. Sorry, I should have possibly. It doesn't really matter, but I could have put that camera over there. But hey, looks like it's turning into something. Nice. And then finally, the neck pickup. And I'm going to just get me a couple of little cable ties for trying to hold these things in a line, because they've got to come down a line together, but that's not yet. So you can see it's not a complicated job doing this. It's nice starting from scratch with a kit instead of trying to work with existing wiring. So those are in. Ooh, located. Take a quick picture of that baby. Oh, hello, Maurice. Nice, nice. Right. So this is the leftover stuff bin over there. Obvious things we need to do. Well, there are the knobs to put on. I've chosen, Mark, to use a slightly older set that I took off something else a while back, just because they're a bit less sort of shiny than the ones you had on there. The new ones just felt a bit... or the Chinese plasticky ones, just for, there's not that much difference, but they just felt a bit horribly garish out of the box. These are a bit more, a bit straighter cut in some sort of strange way. Okay, bags. So, it's a simple task really. What we've got to do is we've got to undo this wiring, and we have to get it to do what we want without stressing it around this point where it comes out of the pickup. And to me, that's one of the weakest parts of this, and I've seen pickups conk out because of that. I really get nervous by it, so I'm going to hold it down there as much as I can while I sort of stretch out the rest of it, and then hopefully just don't put any more strain on it after that. The same with this one, but then this one has to go off sideways anyway, because it has to end up over here. So we've got these guys need to come down the middle and basically turn right. You see, and these guys have got to come down here and also turn right, and those guys have just got to turn right from the get-go. So it's something like that. So while I'm at it, I'm just going to cable off these so they stay together. No harm in that. It off. Just can't stop doing this, it's so much fun. Okay, so I'm just thinking, where's this going to sit? Do we need it? It's going to go up and over. I think in reality it's going to go up and over. Left turn there. I'm just going to tie these again with another one. hopefully I'll just keep it, keep that one out of the way. So, you know, with a bit of luck, just keeping everything tidy, and then we can feed it all over to here, which gets a bit messier. Now, every time I try and use the wire strippers, they don't work for me. So I'm going to do what I always do, and I'm going to strip my hand, and it always works for me. So that's the blue wire, which I know is the bridge pickup. The white one is the neck pickup, and the yellow one is the middle. Actually, I may not need all of this wiring, but let's see first before I cut it down to size. I just want to be sure I've got what I need. And the black ones, there we go. So the blacks are three earths, and they should all go, where will they all go? Go to ground. They'll all go to one ground, which I guess will be interesting. Pickup, no, colours correct for iron gear pickups. Well, these aren't iron gear pickups, are they? Ensure all ground connections are soldered together. Right. So, what do I know? I know that they all come together at the top on this pot. So I don't really want so much of this wire. So there's my live wires. Plenty of room, probably too much room. So yellow, let me turn this around now. Oh, well, what I don't know is this is upside down. No, that's right. That's the spring side. Right. So the yellow is going to go to... Yellow is going to go to... 1, 2, 3, 4. There's only four on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And they're staggered. So the yellow is going to go to number two. Blue is going to go to number one on this side. One blue, two yellow, three white, four is the jumper across, which we're going to use. What are we going to use? What colour? They've got red. It could be bare wire, or it could be a bit of red, or something else. So yeah, this is where I have to talk to myself a lot to make sure I get this right. Because, of course, they assume conventions, wiring conventions, that they assume you obviously know about. So, let's just see, we're all going to take these, all these blacks are going to go to this one pot. So, frankly, I don't need loads of room. So, I'm going to cut these back already. And that means I can use a bit of this covered material. So those three are going to go to earth here. Where's the ground? Let's have a quick look here. There's a ground that goes to... So your three pickup grounds go to the top of the volume. There's only one capacitor in this setup. Okay, so the three earths from the pickups go over the top of that pot. And then coming out from the side, we have the an earth which goes... Blimey, loads of it. This goes, this earth here goes out to... This one goes out to... Let's see how long it is. Goes to the trem claw. It's not that one and that one. Those two go to the jack plug. I was just measuring it, find out how long it is, really. Just to cut it, give ourselves a bit extra. Right, so I'm just making out the trim claw earth. will earthen the top of that pot. And then the other two we have to make are the jack plug 5 and earth. I've got these two. So I'm not really explaining this very well because I'm sort of not hugely... Oh, Maurice, you scared me. Not hugely expert in it. So I'm following the instructions, obviously, and before I get the soldering iron out, I'm getting this all positioned, and then when I do get the soldering iron out, I know where everything's got to go. The rule says you need to tin everything, all your bare ends, and I sometimes do, and sometimes I don't, when, for example, it's easier just to hook them into these things here, wherever they go. So if I can hook them in place, then I can come and solder them in. So I can do them without kind of fully committing to them with solder. If I tin them right now, then what happens is I can't bend them in the same way. It means I can't thread them and curl them round. Right, so I've got my three earths together there, and I might as well twist them if I can. Pretty stiff, actually. Twist them into one lump and cut off any sort of excess which I don't really need dangling around. So there's my three earths from the pickups. I can just fix them there when the time comes. Put a bend in there. Then I've got my various things. So on the far side, on number 2, is the yellow. So if I want to, I can just right now thread this through and bend it back on itself, and that gives me a connection already. So the next one in the line is the first one is blue, which is this one, painted blue with a marker pin. So position number 1 is blue. Again, hook that round. That's nicely easy to solder when the time comes. So blue. So we've got blue, which is bridge pickup. Yellow, which is middle. We've got white here, which is neck pickup. And the white one goes to the third of these three. It's got a bit, I think there's a bit too much wire going on there, so I'm going to cut this short a little bit. I don't want too much stuff kicking around everywhere. Okay, so white is number 3. Bend it over, make it easy. White's number 3, and then what we have is number 4. 4 is a jumper across to 1 on the other side. Now, these guys have done it red here. Doesn't really matter what colour it is at all. I might as well use a bit of yellow. So there's my earth wire. It's trouble with doing short bits, hard to handle. Come on. Thank you. Right, so there's my jumper piece from 4 across to 1. Have I given myself enough room? I think I have. Now 4 is also shared with something else here, but I can just hook this thing in and lightly attach it on both. Good. that out. There's my jumper. Next thing we have to do is out of the seam one here on this side, we have a one going to, and this is where it goes upside down. Now let me just try and read this map. Is the spring meant to be the other way around? Is it upside down? That's what I'm concerned about. If I'm following the orientation here, it's upside down currently. Let's turn this round, make sure we've got it all oriented the right way. Otherwise we'll be pushing up for the bridge and down for the neck. So I'm just gonna literally spin all that round and assume this is the correct way for now. Just recheck and make sure everything's sitting correctly now. It's not exactly a 3D picture, or that's sort of trying to pretend to be. I think this probably just about makes sense. So where are we? Okay. So let's just run this by myself again. Got that one hooked in there. Just make this one a bit longer before it bends. So I have a lot of slack going on here. I don't really want that much, but some excess off. Okay, that one's round, this one's off. So we're going jump from one on this side across to four on that side, that's right. Blue in the first position, which is jumped off. Okay. Up you come, blue. Right, and probably a bit too much wire dangling around. So there's my three main wires. There's the jumper. So, and we're looking at first position across the four. Okay. So on this same one, on the far side of there, we're going from there across to the first one, and I'm going to do it. What am I going to do it with? Should I do it with a bit of this? Nice wire, why not? It's all slow. I have to sort of talk my way through these things, because as soon as something's like a bit of a Chinese riddle, I get easily lost. Okay, so we're on the alpha pot here. We're on the first lug. Again, with this I can hook it round. Get my other pliers, needle nose pliers, wherever they've gone. Where? Needle nose, but I can make sure this is squeezed tight together, which then stops it running, moving around. And that one up to this bit here, push it through, bring it up, and okay, close it up with, hopefully, the pliers, not those. Okay, so there's, that's the one up to the jumper point, that's good. Then what else have we got? We've got some yellow going on here. Let's pull some yellow out. So we've got yellow from the 1, 2, 3rd and 4th position down to the 1st and 1st. So not far to go. Two of these. I don't know why, but I find this much more much easier to do than using the wire cutters. Even if I don't complete the whole thing, I have to just go and cut the last little bit by hand. Right, so what are we looking at? We're looking at position 3 on the switch down to 3 on the switch goes to 1 on this far pot. So 3 on the switch here. Again, I can pull it across. 3 on the switch. Maybe I can even wrap it round. 3 on the switch. 1 on this second tone. Three on the switch to 1 on the tone. And just hook that up if I can, which I can't right now. Hook it up. Fiddly. This is doing all this solder free to begin with. Trouble with hooking it around like this sometimes is you get this big splayed mass of wiring. Okay, so that's 3 to 1 on the second tone, and the next one is 4 to 1 on the first tone. On the second, 4 to 1 on the first. Sounds like a race, horse racing odds or something. What did I say? 4 to 1. 4 to 1 on the second. Okay. 4. I suppose the tinning bit does at least stop things splaying, but to be honest, it would make getting the bend through here very difficult. Okay, 4 to 1 on there. That's good. Then we need to do a jumper from 3 on this pot to mid on there, but that also shares through with the leg of this thing. I don't know if it's a one-way thing or not, but do what it says. So I've borrowed a bit of wire off this, so I'm hoping I've got enough. Probably. I don't quite know where it will sit, but oop. That onto there, and then what we're talking about, the end one. I'm just making a little hook. So what I'm doing lug number 3 to the top of itself. So lug number 3, bend it around a bit more, lock it off with the pliers. There you go. And then that will go to the top. And hopefully that will fit in the gap, I hope. And then in the same one, I've got a jump across the middle. Let's use one of these nice bits. A jump across the middle from 3 on the first tone pot to middle on the second tone pot. Cool. And this is sharing that one with the capacitor. Again, I'm just bending this round so hopefully it will make all of the attachments a lot easier. And then, oh, it's come off. Ah, that's not good. Come off completely. So I must have cut that through. Right, just going to remove the excess. I'll try again with this same bit of wire. Right. It's all fun without any soldering anyway. Right, let's go back to this one. Myself a head start with a bit of a bend. I think this this metal that these little wires are made out of, I don't think they tolerate too many bends, to be honest. Okay, so third position to the middle. Oh no, I think this is going to snap as well. Is it? Yep. Damn it. It doesn't like to bend. Right, I'm going to use another kind of wire. I'm going to cut out like that again. Let's go for something ordinary, shall we? Sod your fancy cloth-covered stuff. Waste of time. What we want is good old-fashioned braided wire. Or multi-strand wire, I should say. Right. Okay, so doing right with moths in here tonight. So through this one, nicely done. Easy. Thank you. Over, pardon me. Right, that's 3 to the middle, which goes through quite easily. Finally, and then pulled up. And do a little bit of a wrap around. Okay, with my capacitor flailing about all over the place. Looking good. Right, what are we missing from the top here? Okay, so now we need some yellow and some black, and that's going to make a bit of the black we know is going to make our earth lead, and that's going to join one of these pots. Do we care where? Ground. Now, does that mean get off? I think this first one needs to be grounded. So that means the lug has to be grounded to itself. So, damn these flying creatures. My fault for standing here with the door open. So So there's a bit of this, and I think this one, sorry, capacitor, clumsy, this one goes on here. We could just bend it back and solder it, which some people do, but I'm gonna use a little piece of wire and we're gonna squeeze it on itself. I'm gonna go up to the top there, cut it here. Right, so that's gonna go to the top, and it's gonna go, gonna go to ground. They're all going to go to ground on top of that one. That's also going to go to ground, which is going to the claw, the tremolo claw, which is this one here. So in a way, this one could just as easily join with this one. If I make two little loops, then they can both stick down on the top. Come on. My hands are not built for this. I'm a bit too clumsy. Okay. You wrap around there. You close there. Okay, so they both go on top there. Oh yeah. Right, so that goes to ground. We know that. Now we just have to organise the black and the yellow to go to the thing that's called the jack plug. But we don't want to do it until we've got it through the hole and out the other side. So I just need to make some length to do that. And I can gauge the length by using this as a guide on the other side, so it should be enough. Then, once we've done that, we're sort of ready, really, to get into the business of getting the soldering iron going, getting it done. And at this point we will tin these sorts of wires, because it will make it a lot easier to get it through the body cavities. That's the main thing. And we'll treat the yellow as the live on here, which means it will come out of the middle of the first pot, and the earth will come off the top of the first pot as well and go off. Well, it should be earthed to the tremolo claw. So this can also join the party on top of that pot. The earth party. One of the nice things about not knowing much about this is how much fun it is learning to do it. And starting to find out and do a bit of reading and so on. Okay, so if I want to, I can stick this one into that little junction there. We get all three of these nailed down together. Come on, sucker. Get it to wind round a bit, but you never can get the grip on it. So all of this lot is going to stick to the roof. That's there, and then this one has to just come out the middle of the volume pot and head off towards the jack input as well. Little flies now are everywhere. Not so great, because I've got lots of little bits of wire sticking out, but right. So that, ladies and gentlemen, is my little arrangement ready to go. I'm proud to say. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Quick old picture. Oh yeah. Will I fire up the thing now?
Yeah, why not?
Let's get them all nailed down. And then we can leave the actual installation till another day. Grit paper, and I'm gonna I forgot something. Da da da. I know where that's earthing, but I don't know where this is earthing, so I've got to earth that one to the top of that one. So I've got to chain these three together, which means I need a couple more bits of. Is that earth? No, that isn't. That isn't. And that's going to there. And yeah, so they've all got to be connected to earth, and the source of earth, if you like, not really the right expression, but the earth comes in from there, jumps across to that one, has to jump across to this one. That's the only thing I had missed in this combination so far. So I will tin all of these remaining loose ends, and I'll also be just sandpapering the top of these pots as well, so I can get a good proper silvery connection. Right, come on. I wasn't intending to do this, but hellfire. Having such a good time. Okay, so bits sticking out everywhere, let's just wrap them around so it's a bit tidier. Right, so do a little quick bit of sanding on these pots. Basically making some raw metal for solder to stick to. Alright, so I'm going to do several things, I suppose. I'm going to tin some loose wires, and then I'm going to put some solder onto the tops of these pots. I'm going to spread it on a bit, and then I'm going to start welding the bits and pieces, you know what I mean. How are we doing? So I guess I probably need my little pair of arms. For holding things like this while I just tin them. I find these quite difficult to use, these little devices, but they're still better than nothing. In a way. First one. Second one. Sorry if the view isn't so high tech, if it could be. Okay, those are some of the tinned ones. Let's lift this one up for a second. To the claw, this one goes to the output jack plug. Dangle. This one goes to the live of the jack plug. Okay, those are the, I guess I could do this one while I'm at it, this cluster here. Right, so, I'm going to drop some onto the tops of the pots really. Careful not to be burning something else along the way. There's always a risk of something touching. Come on then. Okay, so things I want to do. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to stick on, want to stick on the, can you see, I'm going to stick on the capacitor. And I'm going to use my needle nose pliers here just to hold down while I heat up the solder and just let the capacitor sink. Now typical, it's now refusing to heat up the solder. Come on. Come on. Hoping that will hold it down. Okay, so that's one difficult one on. Now I'm going to put these, hopefully put these on to it, on top of here. Might need more, a bit more depth of solder for this because it's quite a big chunk of wire, but let's see. Might be alright. Hey, I'm getting good at this. Sort of. Okay, I'm going to put some more solder on here. Because I'm going to need a separate connection. I don't mind if it's got lots on there, to be honest. So, I've got this little unit union here that I want to get happily sunk into the solder. It's not a very easy joint, so I'm going to add some solder to it and then take over with the needle nose pliers at this point so I can let go with the soldering iron, I hope. The plan. Yep, good. So just pushing that out of the way. Now I can start to concentrate on the one by ones. So this little one down here. Again, I just don't want anything to catch fire all around it. So it says gentle as I can be. Come on, damn you. And what I don't like the look of down there is it looks like there's a little crossover that sometimes I don't think this should be that way. So I don't know how I'm going to get this out. This is where I'm not too keen on this whole game, because I think there's a little bridge of solder down here that I didn't want to make. It's made a contact that I don't want. I can't get into it. See either very well. Is that part of the same thing? Well, I think it is, so I don't think it's a problem if it touches. Okay. Right, let's not panic too much. So those are attached. Let's get back into it. Let's get this one done. Nope. It's not closing up that gap. Now it is. Thank you. Let's run under there, which I don't like. Sometimes I feel like at any moment when I'm doing some soldering, I think it feels like the whole thing should be upside down so I could control the direction that the solder flows in. Sometimes gravity doesn't not feel like my friend at all in this matter. Like that one is not closing the gap up. Come on. Thank you. Okay. Now we're onto these around here. Sorry if you can't see very well. Looks okay. Yep. Again, I'm very careful of the wires and where the heat's going. See when it starts smoking, that's the other thing. I think that one's on, good. And this one has got two joints on it, so I'm going to be careful to get both. It's a bit hot around here, not happy. Hold on now. What did I just do? Oh, That looks about okay. Nice and solid. Yep. So I'm making my way there slowly but surely. Going there slowly but surely. That one at the bottom is done, yep. A bit more solder. I've got to get in and out around some of these little tight ones here, so let's do the capacitor first. Looks good. I'll do this other one on this side after I've just pulled this extra bit round to try and tidy it up. Unsuccessfully, I might add. Good. And this one here sticking out of it. Better. It's trouble with these. Look at the cable on this soldering iron everywhere. Come on. Big blob gone down the side. Damn. Okay. You're done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Done. All I'm missing now is the jumpers from across the top to across the top. And that should be fairly simple to do. Come on. Bit more extra that one there. Press this one out of the way slightly. Almost there. Very intense little process, really. You're on. Good. Freeze. Thank you. And a bit more solder on here. Cool, cool, cool. Lovely. So there we have it. All our bits soldered, all in order, all ready to go. Of course, proof of the pudding will be in the trying it out. Hopefully, I'm not going to do it now, but hopefully everything is laboriously stepped through. Just for my information, I know it's kind of obvious, but I'm just going to put a piece of tape around the pair that go to go out to the whatchamacallit jack plug, which is these two here. And this other one goes to the what's it, you know what I mean. Okay, let's undo that. That goes to the tremolo claw. So really, that is just a few steps away now. Since I'm such a impatient git. Maurice Maddison. Oh yeah, what we realised is we can't do that without taking the neck off again. Yeah, the thing I realised was that the pickguard won't go under the overhang of the neck unless I take the neck off first. So I sort of made up my mind which way around to do it. It's not a big deal because we can easily place that. Nearly there. Right. Get those off to one side. Out with yonder neck for a minute. Sit there. So this is probably an easy way of doing it anyway. So we have these two little bunny rabbits through there. Nice. This little darling through the back there. Not where I want it to go, but that'll do for now. Now I'm interested in what fits where. And will my capacitor actually fit in at all? So now we'll find out. So we need our wires to come round this way. Sorry. You can come out of the way. Basically, we're going to have a look from this side to see what we've got. Those two for a start, because they've got to come all the way through. Get them out of the way of everything else. Okay. Oh, look at that. They may just have, or may not have. I may not have done something. So, what have we got going on here? So something getting in the way of this moving to one side. A bit better, but it's not coming around there. Why is it not coming around there? Something in the way. Do you know what it is? God, it's the size of the pots. Scuppered. What a swine. Absolute pig. Okay. We've got an interesting situation here now, Mark. We've got a pickguard that will sit down, let's get off there first of all. It will sit down in two places there. The rest is, most of the rest is off the mark. So there's a few places there, and from here it's going to sit elsewhere. So I need to peg these down and mark some new holes for this to work. That's interesting. Okay, not really surprised. We have some pick guard screws, please. One, two, three. Right, so I'm going to just prove to myself is where we can line this up, and then where we're going to have to drill other holes. Oops, what's that? Not only are we going to have to drill some other holes, we're going to have to cut the pickguard as well, but that's okay, it's not a problem. Do that in a nice square shape. I'm just going to do these up. Right, that's the important bit, that this neck pocket lines up. And we've got the two here that line up, and the neck pocket lines up, and then this top one here also lines up. Everything else after that goes a bit wonky. And then we've got a bit of plastic that has to come off there as well to make this work. Annoying. You've got this, basically you've got these pots that are too big. It's not gonna, is it gonna go down? Just bloody cheap Chinese crap. Okay, now I've got to try and draw myself a line, determining where it's not sitting properly. Lordy, this is where I'm going to have to cut. Actually, it's further than that, isn't it? That's the cut, and that will sit down there and it will just fit, and then we've got new holes to make. Blimey. Okay, so out with these first of all. I'm going to put this on hold then. It's too late now for this, but at least we know where we stand. Top three go in, and then time for a bit of sawing and shaving. Put those back in there. Yes, in there, along with that, and those for now. Okay, out you come. So all of that stuff sits down there. Okay. Well, funny old thing. So we're going to end up with some new holes. Basically, these pots are larger. Well, this guitar is only designed for the smaller pots, which isn't great. So that's, otherwise it's not so bad. I'm just going to press all this stuff down out of the way. So it's all tucked away as best we can. I think that went like that, didn't it? So that's not too bad, but we do have this cutting job to do now, which won't be the easiest thing in the world because it's attached to this. Okay, I'm going to take a picture of it. I'm going to hang this back up out of the way safely, and I'm done till the weekend. So, the non-standard Stratocaster rears its head and makes things difficult for us, but we will persevere. It will not be impossible. Maurice Caster, he's got over there. Make sure everything I need is put in the right place, and then a bit more wiring, which we don't need, a couple of tips, which we do need. Well, I enjoyed that up to a point, up till it frustrated us. But that's often the case, so we're going to, you can see we're going to cut this bit out here, which will accommodate everything. We'll just squeeze these pots in to the cavity and it will work, no problem. But it means we also have to, apart from the top three holes there, we also have to dremel some holes to go in. I'll fill the other ones so they don't look so ugly, the ones we don't use. But there you go. Okay, Mark, a couple of days off in the city now doing consultancy work, so I'll see you at the weekend.